When it comes to working from home, distribution of spaces is crucial as it determines your level of productivity and reduces or increases distractions. Ooh, put it on me. Today, you'll see an example of a two-bedroom apartment layout and the perfect area for your home office, even if you don't have a separate room for that. I'll show you how to set it up properly. Also, I'm gonna show you how to lay out your work area on a floor plan quickly. Actually, not only your workspace, but the whole apartment. Let's go. All my work is digital, so having a proper workspace is absolutely necessary for me. What you're now seeing was the first attempt to set up my home office. Like the majority of people, I also thought that the perfect area for my desk would be by the window, and I still do. But at that time, the position of the table was inconvenient. No place for a little cabinet to store documents, to set up a lighting, not to mention no filming corner for my videos.
It feels right. So 6 months after working like that, I decided to restructure my office area and set it up in a more logical and productive way. And here are my top 5 questions to ask when choosing the space for it in your home.
First of all, define your work priorities. Here's my example. As the majority of my work consists of filming, lessons for my course on interior drawing, live workshops for our ASDB students, webinars, reels, online lessons and conferences, etc. Having a filming corner with natural window light was my main priority. So I decided to turn my desk 90 degrees so that I still have the window on the left and no distractions in the background for my videos. The second thing I did was to define other work priorities. Accounting, printing documents, all of this needs additional space. After changing the position of the table, I got an empty area where the table was. This is where my little cabinet and a printer sit. It's not far from the desk, and all of this still has its own place in my office. You sick of all the same dudes running up. Lighting. Ask yourself whether it is enough for you to have natural light from the window, or do you need extra lighting? In my case, I did, because the windows in my apartment block some of the light and tint it. So sometimes I get a green light and I definitely don't need that. That means that I needed an extra spot for all my lighting. Lamp mobility was also important, so I moved the table slightly to the back, closer to the bookshelf, and cleared some space for the lamp. Now I can freely move it where I need to and get fantastic light from every angle. Of course, you can try out various design ideas without having to move any furniture, and I'm now gonna show you how. For our makeover, we'll need an iPad or any other drawing tablet, and an Apple Pencil or any other electronic pencil compatible with your drawing device. I'll be working in the Procreate app. Whether you buy or rent your apartment, there is always a floor plan for it. And this is the floor plan of mine. This is a JPEG picture, which I'm now gonna insert into Procreate. The quality of the floor plan leaves a lot to be desired, so I'm now going to draw the walls manually. Yeah, I'm the one who looks you in the eyes. Speaking like I mean it, what's inside, I don't want. No, these are just try and play the part. But I'm the one who made it to your heart. As we see, there are no dimensions, so I'm going to find them manually. To do so, I'll be working with the 2D grid. Interior sketching is so helpful for these kinds of makeovers. A couple of months ago, I filmed another YouTube video about a kitchen makeover where I showed how to insert furniture. You can find the link in the upper right corner of the screen. So, back to our floor plan. Given the dimensions, I can start working with the furniture. Since I already have their measurements, it's easy to draw them correctly. You see how easily you can move your furniture and play around with the position. You can experiment as much as you want till you've found the perfect fit. Once we're done with the contours, it's time to bring our drawing to life. Start with adding a base color and getting rid of white spots. Then apply light and shadows. It's a must when working with interiors in order to add three-dimensionality to your sketch. We usually finalize the illustration by adding details. This is the workspace on my hand-drawn floor plan, And this is how it turned out in reality. Every bit of it was done in Procreate. The full step-by-step tutorial can be found in my complete course on interior drawing. We still have two more things to discuss when decorating your workspace. Don't clutter the table, which happens to me pretty often. Leave only the basics on the desk. In my case, I need my laptop, iPad, magazines for daily ideas, markers, pens, planners and sketchbooks. The rest has been hidden in the cabinet and on the shelves. I decided to place my home office area in a separate room than the bedroom because I wanted to sleep without having to see the work before going to bed and right after waking up. As much as I love my work, I still needed to switch myself off.
Here are the principles of organizing your home office area at home in a nutshell. Define your work's priorities, other work priorities which need additional space, lighting, natural and artificial, organizing your desk and separating areas. Thank you so much for watching and see you in the next makeover.